Auf der NAB-Show 2016 stellt Atomos vor allem das Thema HDR vor. Und da gibt es gleich mehrere Produkte, die spannend sind. Jeremy,
yes.
Let's talk about your newest product.
Yes.
It's a big inferno, I have heard. What can you tell us about the inferno?
Well, the name inferno means a big fire. And what it is, that is the HDR boom that is happening today in video. And it's all about brightness, so flame and inferno. And the inferno goes at 4K P60, which we haven't been able to do before. We tried on the Shogun, we said we possibly could do it. I didn't promise, and unfortunately we couldn't. Technically, we couldn't do it. So now we've upgraded that processor inside the unit and rewrote everything for 4K P60. So now we can do 4K P60 from those cameras that can do 4K P60. Yeah. And that's what Inferno does.
And what kind of connection is used for that?
Okay, so yeah, we've got 4 BNCs, 3 gigs, so you can do all those cameras like Vericam, the F55, the C500, all of those wonderful cameras that don't have 12 gig. We thought they would, but they didn't, so it's taking a bit of time. Yeah. So you can still go 12 gig in if something gives you that. Or you can go 4 BNCs in from those cameras, and then you can loop out 12 gig or loop out. So it's a converter at the same time.
Okay.
But yeah, it comes in four BNCs.
Okay. And HDMI is also supported?
Absolutely, right there. And that's because Shogun, the name, means HDMI SDI. Ninja, the name, means HDMI. Right. Samurai, the name, means SDI only.
But this HDMI is even better than the last one?
2.0. 2.0A, yeah. Actually, which means we can support the metadata query to the HDR TVs that are coming to allow you to pick the right curve for HDR to send to the TV depending on its nit value.
Yeah.
And very important, because LG will make a 400 nit panel, someone else will make a 800 nit panel, someone will make a 400 nit at 10,000 to 1 contrast ratio, which means they're using contrast more than they are the nit values, whereas the higher the nit values, they use less contrast ratio.
Yeah. But depending on LCD or OLED.
Yes, and it ends up with the same result, provided you got one of them right really high, then everyone's happy.
Okay. And who needs HDR?
Well, everybody needs HDR. Everybody. Yes, and everyone can have it today, actually, because most people have bought a Canon, a Sony, or some good camera, and they have log on it.
Yeah.
Log equals HDR. HDR equals log.
Yeah.
There is no HDR without log. RAW is also part of that, because log is inside the RAW. But you need the full dynamic range, the full brightness range of the sensor, which we have never been able to display in the past.
Okay.
There are two parts to each standard for video. There is brightness and color. HDR is all about brightness. You can stay at a higher HDR brightness display curve. And what there's two parts to the actual acquisition and display side. So the log curve is the acquisition side. Display curve is the exact opposite of that, to display it properly. So when you actually display the HDR, you have a couple of choices. You can try to display something like a Sony log or a Canon log, but that's not going to work. And we need a standard across the TVs. So what that standard is PQ or 2084. And what that does is just adjust the curve a little bit for brightness display based on the nit value of the panel. So what we're doing is we're recording that log footage and giving you the opportunity to display it correctly so you can expose properly. And then when you finish, you hook our display up, put it into PQ mode, and then you can monitor and edit on set in a 7-inch HDR panel for grading. And this is a 10-bit 1500 nit panel, so it's really, really high quality, very high brightness. So we can show 1500 nits where the sun is or the bright point in the image, and right down to 1 nit, which is the black point. So you get this brightness range going on inside the scene, and we are capable of delivering that with our Atom HDR engine.
So, by saying so, the sensors in many cameras do this high contrast range, and now we have monitors, so we are able to see what's recorded.
What's recorded, and that's a big thing, right?
Yeah.
We're not touching the log footage, we're not adjusting it at all. That all flows right through the process.
Yeah.
What we're doing is just letting you see what it will look like on an HDR display at the end.
Okay, I think that's very important to just explain very clearly, the signal from the camera is recorded one-to-one, so there's no change inside. It's recorded in the full quality, and then just to be able to see that the flat profile usually doesn't look very nice, you can switch to a mode so that you see, wow, here is my real picture.
That's right. And right now I'm in Rec 709, looks overexposed, but as I move down, and let me put on the waveform because that's a really important part of it. So you will see that during this process, I have a, right? So I've got a, I'm overexposed here, and now I'm moving down the curve, and I can get more and more detail. Now, actually, I'm looking at probably, let me punch in a little bit. As I do this, it's just, you just need to see it. Well, sorry. You just need to see it. The detail in her bright areas come back as I move. Now, I don't need all of this dynamic range. The sensor could capture a bit more, but I just want to leave it at the point where this dynamic range of this scene is. And that's what this slider is for. It allows you to make sure you will get the result that you want at the end. And then I can see here I'm 3 stops or 800% of Rec 709. So then that then metadata can travel through the editing package. So you know what the cameraman shot, how he exposed it, which means if you do this correctly, you will be able to produce Rec 709 and HDR. If you get it wrong and you expose like this, Rec 709 is not going to be very good, right? If you go like this all the way down, your HDR is not going to be very good. But if you go right at that sweet spot in the middle, then you have the perfect HDR.
Now, for people who might not have yet a camera with that kind of sensor, is the high brightness of the monitor, is this also something which helps us in regular record situation, maybe outside?
Well, as you know, we live in Australia. The sun is quite bright there. I've been shooting for the last 3 months on this panel at 1500 nits. In Rec 709, you can never not see the screen. It's beautiful. And but so bright that even with the sun directly behind you hitting the screen, you can see and resolve and do what you need to do as a professional.
So you bring out the Australian sun into your product.
That's right, that's right. It's powered, nuclear Australian power inside to display all of the sun.
Okay. Well, that's Atomos.
Atom, exactly.
Okay, well, now you have a bunch of new products like the Shogun Flame, the Ninja Flame, and the Shogun Inferno. And the Shogun Inferno does everything. But what about the smaller products? Would it be nice if they also would have a little bit of HDR?
Yes, and you know what? They do have it. So the difference between a high nit, 1500 nit panel, our older products are all about 400 nits, 350 to 400. Ninja Blade, Samurai Blade. Thank you to all those customers. The next level up was Shogun and Ninja Assassin that made our company, you know, and we're very grateful to those customers. So our thank you to them, to all of those customers who have built this wonderful company that's here, that's supporting all this ecosystem inside and bringing HDR right now to the world in real workflow, real solutions. We are giving for free HDR to all those older devices. Now, we can't display the brightest points at the really bright values like 1500 nit, but we can display them at 400 nit, and we can show you that same range. So the unfortunate bit is it's only 8-bit and 400 nits. The fortunate bit is it's 90% accurate, so you can get really close to the to the same solution as a Flame or an Inferno, which means we're giving them the taste of HDR. And once they see it, I promise you, within the next 1 or 2 years, whenever they can afford it, they will move to the higher value product. And what we understand is that people are at different stages in their careers, people are at different stages in their development of their company, and we are selling to companies that make money from producing videos. We want you to be more profitable. We want you to be the best in your field. We want you to compete on an even playing field and have all the greatest technology today to make your customers happy. And that's what Atomos is about.
Okay, talking about competition.
Yes.
When we entered South Hall, we could see a video assist in a new version, 4K.
Yes.
Is there any comment about this product?
Oh, because absolutely. I've got a big comment about it. It's not HDR. They missed it. They missed the boom of NAB, which is very interesting for that company. I thought there'd be a new camera. There always is 10 new cameras. maybe something's going wrong in the development team. Takes a long time to develop those products by the looks of it.
Well, they have to ship it first.
Yeah, that's right. It takes time to ship, right? The shipping's very difficult. Look, it's SD card based, not affordable media. Yeah. It's not really practical. They're trying to copy us, which is fine. I love people trying to copy us. But what every time that they announce a product, we sell double. So I'm happy. Let them announce new products at 895. Yeah. It's 2 years ago's product. That's a Shogun sitting right there without the waveforms, without the 3D LUTs, without the features that we've been able to develop in our Atom OS for the last 5 years are not in there.
Yeah.
So it's up to customers. I urge you, please try our operating system, try their operating system.
Yeah.
If you want to be in the future and you've got a log camera, you need HDR. And our whole range has HDR, so it doesn't matter which one you want to buy.
Yeah, sure. I get the customers go for the taste of HDR or the real HDR and the real Australian sun.
Correct. 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 We love the sun. We love brightness.
Yeah.
Inferno and flame. Keep it coming.
Yeah. Sounds really great. Thank you very much.
Thank you.